Hey, what's up, guys? This is BSG Trek Fan 88 here for a special, I guess you could call this a review. This is a 160 gigabyte iPod Classic. It has been in my possession for at least 5 years now. This is my second iPod Classic. The first one I bought was the, I think it was 80, whatever the step down was. I know that they made two or maybe three, but this is the highest capacity one. It's seen its fair share of use. I usually, the whole point of me having a Classic was one of two things, and I know I'm really overexposed here, but I'm going to try and fix that in a second. I bought this because I liked the idea of having my entire music library, which has grown, obviously, from my very first SanDisk MP3 player, which was 512 megabytes, all the way up to what it is currently, which is about 115 gigabytes. No other iPod except the Classic can store that much. Now, I have an iPhone now. Before I had an iPod Nano, and I had this. The Nano was kind of like my playlist iPod. I would make playlists specifically for the Nano. This, I can just literally say my whole music library is on this. It's basically a backup hard drive. And after the events of last month, this was the sole remaining, I guess you could say, possession that I have that meant something. I had my radio and for the mail truck, and I had a couple other things in my car, but this is it, okay? And movies can be replaced, my collection can even be replaced, but I have over 15,000 songs. I can't remember all of them. They're albums that I've been buying since high school. So to have this, with the exception of about 500 songs, excuse me. Actually, let me look at my iPod. 14,396. Now, that was actually 15,577, but unfortunately, the data transfer, I lost, do the math, okay, about 1,000 songs. But to be honest with you, when you're dealing with that many songs, I'll take it. So anyway, a couple of the reasons why I'm doing this video is, one, to pay tribute to this, because I am very much a fan of music. I'm not a fan of music that you would consider popular. I collect soundtracks, which is probably half of the music on here. I have pretty much any soundtrack you can think of, with the exception of musicals and chick flicks and things like that. But to have my music collection safe, that means a lot to me. Now, another thing, when I buy products, I try and keep them as clean as possible. I say the same thing with a phone, but eventually the phone's gonna get dirty, it's gonna get scuffed up. I mean, my first iPhone I had since December until the fire, and it was actually in pretty decent shape. Nothing really wrong with it. I can't stand people that scratch the shit out of their phone. But anyway, this is actually the original case that I bought for the iPod Classic. As you can see, it's, it actually has a rubberized coating on the outside, which I love. It's by DLO. But as you can see, it's rubbed away. The back actually looks a lot better. You can see the stickers from Best Buy when I brought this into the store. And what's also cool about this is that it has a kickstand. So, when you're transferring a lot of files, this does heat up. It's nice having this off its back. Also, if you want to watch a movie, I know it's a small screen and people probably didn't watch movies that much on this, but it's nice. I mean, I actually, when I didn't have my other iPods handy, I would use this on planes and things like that. But anyway, what's unique about mine, as old as it is, this is the original plastic that the iPod came with. When you buy them brand new, I don't know if they changed it now, but it came with this plastic surrounding it. So what I did was, day one, I cut off the bottom because it wrapped around it. Let me refocus the camera here. Okay, we're as focused as we're gonna get. I cut a hole, well, not a hole, but I cut the little slip off so I could have access to the USB port here, not USB, the pin connector, whatever the hell Apple used to call it. So this is actually the first time I'm taking this out in a long time. I've taken it out a couple times, but as you can see, it looks pretty dirty. But when you take this off, there's literally, this is basically a brand new iPod. I mean, at the bottom where the connecting pin goes, it's a little, it's not scuffed, it's dirty. If I cleaned it, it would look brand new. But I actually really like the fact that this is in mint condition, basically. I mean, this camera, hello, that's pretty cool. This camera doesn't do it justice at all. And yeah, you can see superficial stuff here, but if I was to take a really nice cloth and buff this away, I mean, you wouldn't see anything. This is excellent condition. I would sell this for almost full price, to be honest with you. But having this, it was actually in my car, in my Ford Escape, because, you know, it's my car iPod. I usually keep this in my vehicle, basically to have my entire music collection handy. I don't think I'm going to do that. I think when I do end up getting some money, I will be buying a iPod Nano, or maybe even a Classic, but I think a Classic's a little too much, so probably just a Nano to keep in my car, because after what happened with the fire, if something happens to my car, you know, I have my music on my computer now, so it's a different situation, but it's one of those things where it's like, do I really need my entire music collection in the car? Yes and no. I mean, it's nice being able to say, oh, I want to listen to this album, and it's not on my phone, so I can't do that, so I have this handy, so, but what do you do? Talk to me in the comments below. You know, do you have something like this where you have your entire music collection and then maybe a phone or something that you have certain playlists on? Do you have multiple, we'll just say MP3 players? It doesn't have to be an iPod per se. And to answer your question you might have, why do I use an iPod? Well, since I had my license, I've had a very keen interest in sound quality in my car. As you all know, I had a very nice sound system in my room. It's different for a car. Not everybody can do it. I pride myself on having quality in my car for sound. So I went with the aftermarket radio. The first one you get when you're a teenager, you just get your license and you want to put a deck in your car. It was just a simple CD deck with a headphone jack. And then they came out with ones with USB, so you can use flash drives and stuff. I mainly use an iPod because I like, after using many of them, my first one was a SanDisk Sansa, which is an amazing MP3 player. For, they don't make it anymore, but back then it was amazing. I like the iPod. You can't really see here. If you've used one before, you know what I'm talking about. I love the interface. It's very simple, especially for handling this many songs and albums. I could scroll forever. Oh, there we go. But with the newer radios that were coming out, they had iPod connectivity, meaning that you could access your music just like an iPod. You know, go into albums, it would show album art, and that's why I bought the Pioneer double-din radio that I have now. I had it in my Corolla, I had it in my Scion TC, I had it, actually the Chevy Blazer was a single-din, I had an Alpine. So basically it comes down to interface. I like the idea of, literally on the Alpine it has a scroll wheel like this, only it's on an LCD display and it's touchscreen, but, you know, pause, select, menu, left, right, track selection, just things like that, simplicity. And of course, the other issue slash problem is I've used iTunes since getting a large music collection, so a lot of files are encoded certain ways. I've bought things on iTunes, and I know that there's other music players out there that I could use, but I like to stick with something I know, you know, and until the day comes where it's really fucked up, like almost it is, because iTunes 11 point whatever it is, I can't stand, so I actually use 10.7, which is the highest 10 that they had before they switched to 11, just because I like the interface. But anyway, like I said before in the comments below, what do you use, what do you prefer, what do you think? Let me know, but, you know, this video is just for the iPod Classic here, because this is the sole remaining thing of mine, collection, personal use, whatever, the remaining item that I have. I will get more items, but, again, having my music, it means a lot to me, so, have a good night, thanks for watching, see you.